Hey guys, and welcome back to more 7 Days to Die. This is a 7 Days to Die mini-series, Fortnite every night, permadeath on warrior difficulty with zombies jogging during the daytime. We also have double the experience and 1.5 times the loot, so 150% loot and 200% experience. This could bite us in the ass because our game stages and our levels are rising faster, so hopefully it's not going to be too fast that we can't deal with the hordes, but we'll see. I don't expect to live long anyway, so just let me knock out the starter quests and then we're going to see where our trader is and where our starting area is. We're playing on a random generated map. The seed is Dawn of the Dead, all lowercase, no spaces in between. I just finished our starter quest and our trader is over there. This is actually the second time I'm trying to record this. The first time I got actually to pick a nice house and we're very lucky that there's a house close to the trader, but I just besawed it out. I was in the middle of preparing for the first horde night and boom, besawed. And for some reason, because I was, I don't know if it was because I was in the middle of recording or if it was just in general the crash, the actual game files of the save game completely corrupted. I couldn't fix it. I tried creating a new game and copying some files over, but it didn't work. So we're coming up here at the trader now, and this is the two houses that are really, really nice right beside the trader. Now, the right one, I think, would be a viable horde house as well. It has a lovely staircase inside. We're going to have a look at later, or after the first horde night, because we're going to have to prepare with this house. But I'm a little bit hesitant yet because I haven't really tried that house before, and I have no idea if it will be enough to just have them come in here or if, because of the size of the building, they're going to start randomly hitting on walls. So this building here, I think this is the same building we tried out during our Horde Night Every Night stream, where we tried out doing Horde Night Every Night from scratch as well. And all we have to do is get rid of the back porch. That way the zombies won't be attracted to the back, because otherwise they will come in here as well, try to hit through the wall. So we're going to replace the door with a wall. And then in the front, there will be the only entrance. And because it's elevated, the zombies just have a knack for continuously looking for the elevated path. So if you're up a block, like you will be here in the house, they won't be coming through the walls that are on the lower block. For some reason, that's just the way the AI works. So on this one here, we have the same setup, but again, because of the size of the house, I'm not sure if the AI pathing and the aggro range they have is going to behave the same. But I definitely want to try it out. So again, this is a Horde Night Every Night with permadeath. If we die because we do something stupid, we're just going to restart. And so be it. I mean, the beginning of the game and the challenges of surviving the initial hordes and getting more harder and harder and trying to survive as long as possible, that's just really what makes this game great. So speeding this up with Horde Night Every Night probably can be a lot of fun. All right, let's check out what the trader has. Hopefully he has some working... Oh, there's more zombies. I thought I heard something else. Oh, nice. Very good. I like it. Working workbench? No, not a working workbench. Okay, but we got a shovel. Very good. I like it. And wow, there's some really eager beavers. We're going to deal with them in a second. We have a car here. Maybe we get lucky and get an engine. Oh, wow. We got some duct tape and we got a treasure map. That is actually going to be really, really awesome. And then we have another car here. And nice, we got some oil and some short iron pipes. So one of the things we're gonna have to do, we want to be really prepared for this. We want to start crafting Molotov cocktails as early as possible. Buy them, of course, grenades, anything that can be thrown at the zombies, because I think the first two, three horde nights maybe, we can do simply by putting a block in front of the door and smacking them and upgrading the blocks around them. But once you get past that, you're going to need more firepower. Oh, working forge. Oh, wow. Forge steel. That is actually really good. I mean, we have loot at 150%, but that doesn't influence the type of loot you get, just the amount of loot. So let's see. Maybe we get lucky with a working chemi station. That would be pretty awesome. Nope. Not happening. And I think that's it. All right. So let's loot the rest of the place. Oh, what do we have here? Oh, cement mixer recipe would have been nice as well. Thank you. Yeah, let's eat and drink a little bit and then talk to the trader and see where he has certain quests. That would be great. Let's see. Wow, they are miles away. So we probably will come back the next day. I mean, 1.1 kilometers is the closest. It's a fetch quest, but I don't think that's something we're gonna have time to do on the first day. So let me just quickly check where that is. It's not too far, but still, it's a good walk. And the treasure map is actually all the way down here, so we're not gonna be doing that anytime soon either. So getting a bicycle as quickly as possible would probably help us a lot, like getting some of these quests done. So let's see what you actually have. I don't think there's anything I can buy straight away. We want to obviously buy as much as possible on ammunition, on weapons, on anything really. So Molotov cocktails, things like that. He doesn't have that, of course. Do you have any guns? Let me see what you have on weapons. Okay, you have a lot of ammunition, which is good. 7.62 ammunition, 9mm ammunition, shotgun shells. Hopefully we're gonna be able to craft a shotgun ourselves rather quickly. What do we need to actually craft a blunderbuss? We need glue. We already have one glue, and we have some bones, and we have some water. We don't have any water, but we have some empty jars, and the closest water is here. We might have a look here and see if we can find a pool or something. Here we are. So this... Wow. Okay, I just walked right in. Okay, there's obviously something upstairs. Let's give us a little bit of room. Interesting, he's coming, trying to come through the floor. Oh, we completely missed him. All right, before we're gonna get started with the looting, let's make a little bit of room, put some chests down, and get rid of our load. And then we're gonna loot this place. We also have very little time to clear out the deck. Is that something we can loot? Oh, excellent, okay. And the car as well, might as well while we're here in the back. And also we have to put our, oh, nice, look at that, that is awesome. And we can use that axe instead. Very nice, I love it. Yeah, this is the only downside, being close to a trader. You have to put your land claim blocks so far back, but some of the house, most of the house is included in the area. So we're gonna be doing okay. And on top of that, we're going to place a bed in our house as well. So that should give us a little bit of additional safety as well here on the parts where this area is not covering it. All right, we got everything sorted out. Everything's put away. I'm going to probably go with a sledgehammer, and for general questing or when we're out and about, I probably will use just the wooden club. But for Horde Night, where we have a little bit of time relaxing between attacks because we have like barriers there, we're probably going to use the sledgehammer. So I might be putting points into Skull Crusher and Boomstick because a shotgun is really what I'm after. So the shotgun would probably help the most, and then if we can find an AK-7 at the trader at some point or something, that would be great. Or any other gun, like a pistol would do as well. We should start seeing pistols in loot at some point as well, and little shotguns as well, the initial shotguns. But if we can craft ourselves at least a blunderbuss for when the Horde Knights get a little bit heavier before Horde Knight 2, that would be great. So let's loot the house and then get rid of the back of the patio so we can... Actually, let's do the patio first because otherwise we're gonna get caught out. We can always loot when it gets dark, but the patio is probably the most important. So let's get rid of that first. So the back door is closed now, so the little bit of work we have left to do is to replace the front with proper stairs so that they can come up. They have a tendency of actually hitting the railings and hitting this, so we want to make sure that we're going to put stairs up for everything that they can reach comfortably then. So we're going to have to put stairs up here. Let me just check that if that is going to be high enough. I hope so. I hope they aren't going to hit that wall. They should come to the door. I mean, there should be no reason for them not to come to the door, to be honest. There we go. And... yeah, let's put that here as well. We'll see how it goes. If they start coming through the wall, we're just gonna block this side off here completely. And we're just gonna make sure that they literally have no reason not to come up here. And I think for the first Horde Knight, we also wanna make sure that we have the windows covered. So we have to make sure we're gonna put that in as well. Close the windows off. We don't wanna be able to see anything. I was going to put bars there, and then I was thinking, no, the bars are pretty weak until you can upgrade them. So they would probably attract them more to hit them. This is literally the same as you always would start with Horde Knight. Every night, that's plenty. Absolutely plenty. So we want to put a hatch here so we can go in and out. They don't seem to hit the hatch. I don't know why they don't do that. I haven't seen any zombies yet hitting hatches that were on the top. Oh, there's the warning. There we go. So, and for some reason, they don't seem to hit that. So we can go in and out, and then all we have to do is jump in, and then we can close this, and that's it. So we can upgrade this block here fully to cobblestone. I made a couple of cobblestone, and we have only limited dirt, so 50 cobblestone will be enough, which is 5 blocks. And how much wood do we have? Okay, yeah, we definitely need to get a little bit more wood. So let's finish the stairs, finish the wood, and then loot this place here and see what we're gonna get. We might find actually something nice. Let's actually do the bookshelf while we're here. Look at that, nice. So we have the loot at 150, which means sometimes it gives you 1 and sometimes 2. So sometimes it seems to be random that it sometimes rounds up and sometimes down. Which is not bad, because this is an extra 160 quid we can actually make money off. Okay, so we're just gonna finish up. We have very little time left, and I don't know if we have to close this off if they're gonna try to come in anywhere else. I don't think so. Ah, well, it's only the first Horde Knight, so the worst that can happen is that they try to break somewhere through. It should only be about 2 or 3 of them. That is the maximum we get. What is the game stage we're at the moment? We're game stage 2 and level 2, so as long as we stay below level 5 on the first Horde Knight, we should be fine. But I think regardless, we get only 2 or 3. So I think this is enough upgrading 2 rows for now on the front. That should be plenty. And can we upgrade this as well? I think we have a little bit of iron. We could give that the iron treatment, I think. Okay, that's 12. Yeah, absolutely. We may be even be able to turn that into a iron hatch. Oh, that is very nice. We have 42 iron left. That is sweet. Okay, it's done. There we go. Nice. And then we can put another little upgrade on it. Oh, that was 40. But yeah, that means in case they do hit it, we actually have it covered. That is really good. We wasted all our iron on it though. We have a little bit more clay soil left, so let's make a couple of more cobblestone. And I suppose that's it. The rest is waiting it out. Luckily, this is gonna be the second level upgrade already, which means the next level is cobblestone. So the aim is to have by night 3, I suppose, everything cobblestone upgraded. And that's it. I think this is all we're gonna do. Just in case, we probably should have some blocks here blocking this off. So just so that they don't get attracted to this space. And then we can upgrade the rest of the wall here as well. And we're still gonna have to do a little bit of looting. So hopefully we can do that just as the Horde Knight starts. Okay, we're gonna leave the door open just in case it starts. 15 minutes left. We might as well take that time to loot up. Have a little bit of time. I'm sure we can find something.
Trader Joel's is now closed.
Okay, there's nothing in this room here. Oh, we now have a wrench, so we can actually take these guys apart. Oh, this is very good for some extra clay. And we have... Oh, very nice. I like that. And with the wrench, we can take this apart for some extra parts, but I'm actually after leather mainly. So let's see if... Do we need these shoes? 4-3 cold heat resist. Yeah, definitely gonna wear them. Here we go. Here it begins. Do we have anything in here? Nice. We have a bag here. Some healing maybe. Oh, nice. That was good timing. Okay, let's go downstairs quickly before they change their mind. All right, let's do it. Let's actually swap these guys around. That way we can set them on fire. And then once they're burning... Come on, there we go. We can slap him. There we go, nice. Okay, actually, you know what? Let's just put that here. Nice. Ooh, right. Oh, wow, we're already out of stamina. Okay, we're gonna have to go with the little club here. There we go, nice. Okay, that is lovely, nice. Okay, we're level 3 now, but again, we have 200% experience, so that's expected. Oh, I thought you were done for it. Okay, come on, stamina. Don't fail me now. There we go, beautiful. And I think that is literally it. That is the first Horde Knight. So we should have very little damage here. Very good, I like it. And we need some more torches. I think we can craft some more torches here. Yeah, we have two more fat. Cloth we need as well. There you go, we need two cloth. Brilliant. So that way we can put a torch actually behind us so we can see the faces of the things we kill next time a little bit better. So there we go. And that's actually a lot of light. Yeah, that's much better than I thought. So we might put another one here just so we have really a lot of light. And that's it. And then we can put the other one into our hand and swap between smashing with clubs and stone hammers and torches. Absolutely fantastic. Look at that. Repair, and we haven't spent any points yet. I'm a bit hesitant on spending points. So, because I'm not really sure what route I want to go down to. I think I want to go down the Boomstick Road, but I'm not sure between Skullcrusher and Pummel Pete. Because the Skullcrusher, like right now, we've seen how much the Sledgehammer actually takes on stamina. And I think this will give us, does that make the stamina cost less? With a little luck and sometimes knockdown guaranteed, craft quality too poor, more damage, 15%, knock them down. Okay, and then we need Sexy Saurus as well. Yeah, so we definitely want Sexy Saurus, Skullcrusher, Pummel Pete, but there's some things we must take because we can't rely on RNG. We don't have the luxury of waiting. So we need to unlock the forge. We need to. We definitely want Master Chef 1 so we can make the teas, which I think covers red tea and red tea. Excellent. So that will actually make drinks very, very beneficial for us already, which is really nice. And it allows us to make bacon and eggs. So I think these are the things we must take if we're playing with Horde Knight every night. And then, yeah, let's just make a call on it. Okay, so let's just go Sexy Saurus anyway. We have to do that. Let's go with strength. And do we want to go another strength and another Sexy Saurus? And then we can decide on these points in the next Horde Knights. I don't think we need anything here. Yeah, I think we're going to do this. End of story. There we go. And we're going to go with another Sexy Saurus. So I think that will definitely help us now with the melee combat in the next Horde Knight. Excellent stuff. So we're going to start the episodes usually around 4, I would say. So let's see if we can finish looting this room properly. There's no secret spaces here, is there? And what do we have? We have, let's repair that, scrap that. Beautiful, I like it. And also we can scrap this. Oh, this is perfect because now look at this. This is gonna be beautiful. I think we have everything we need. So, oh, this is brilliant that it actually goes into 3 bones. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And we need one drink like this. Now we can take this out. We can make a single glue, I think. What else do we need? Oh, we need the cooking pot. Yeah, okay. Yeah, but this is going to be our next glue. Then we have 2 glue, and then we can make ourselves a blunderbuss, which means we're just going to have to do some blunderbuss ammo, which is simply gunpowder, stone, and paper, which we already have a few off here. That is actually really good. I like that. We're definitely gonna loot the neighbor's house. We're gonna try to do a quest, the neighbor's house, and yeah, this quest and at least a couple of houses here. We have always the houses and they're dungeons like, so which is really good. So we should get some nice rewards and we definitely should try to sell things as much as possible to the trader as well. Anyway, I think we're in good shape. Hopefully forge next episode, then we can go and start making cement and prepare for that, and the concrete mix, the cement mixer is only a couple of levels down, and then we're set to go. I think it went all right. I think we're on a good way. Let me know as well in the comments below what you think we should be looking after. Molotov cocktails, of course, pipe bombs, well, they might cause a bit of damage, but anything with fire is always good. And cobblestone rocks and cement, we're going to be buying that from the trader. What other items would you look out for on a Horde Knight every night playthrough? with the trader that you want to buy. Let me know in the comments below. Anyway, I'm gonna leave this episode here. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, remember to kick that like button in the balls, and I hope I see you guys in the next video. And if you're new to the channel and you like what you see, hit that subscribe button, and I see you guys next time. Until then, as always, viel Spaß and happy gaming. I know we already finished the episode and we had our outro, but the question does come up a lot. Do I not have a second wave of zombies in the first Fortnite? No, I don't. So as soon as we finished this, I went outside and I've been hitting stone and... Oh, is that coal? Oh, nice. That is such a good find. That is beautiful. Okay, let me get my light source here. So anyway, I don't seem to get a second wave in the first Fortnite after the initial one. Even if it's finished the initial wave at 10:30, that's it. You can literally go out on the first night straight away and in complete safety, go out and collect whatever you need. It should not be a problem. And we gotta keep an eye on it though, because at some point the Horde Knights will become two waves. And I don't know exactly at which Horde Knight that happens, if it's based on how many nights you already played the game or if it's based on your game stage and level. I'm not sure.